Hey, it's Eric here. Let's go ahead and talk about the advanced operators in Scratch. I want to focus now on these bottom three operators right here, and these deal with text. So we look at the top here and we see join the word hello with the word world. So you're probably wondering, why do we have a block that separates the words hello and world? Why not just say hello world? Well, let me explain it this way. These words can be changing dynamically based on other blocks. So for instance, we could develop a block that says join the word hello with the name of the user. So let's go ahead and try this out. If you recall, we have a sensing block that asks for the user's name. So it's right here, ask what is your name, okay? And when we answer this question, we'll be given a value. So right now, we can see that value here, and we don't have a value. So if I go ahead and run this project, what is your name? Well, my name is Eric. Okay, so our answer is Eric, and that data exists in this block. So we know we want to use this block. So we'll go ahead, just drag it over here, let it hang out. And now what do we do with this block? Well, we want to join the words hello with the data in our answer. So we'll go ahead and just simply nest this in that join block. So instead of world, we want to join the answer. So there we are. Now what do we do with this block? We have join, hello, and world. So what do we want to do? We want our sprite to say this. And you know this, we have a say block. So instead of saying hello, we want them to say hello, Eric. Cool? So we'll just go ahead, pop this in. And if all goes according to plan, our sprite should ask our name. And then for 2 seconds, it should say hello and input our answer right after that. So let's go ahead and try it. What's your name? My name is Eric. Hello, Eric. Pretty cool, right? So let's go one step further. We see that right now when I enter my name, Eric, the formatting doesn't look great. You'll notice there's no period at the end. So hello, Eric. Well, that doesn't look that great. So first of all, let's change our H to uppercase. And let's show how you can nest a join inside of a join. So right now it says, say hello, Eric. I want to join at the end here a period. So what I'll do is grab another operator block, the join, and I want the first text string to be hello, Eric. And at the end, I want to attach a period or an exclamation point. So let's go ahead. We'll put it back in and we'll see that it will say hello, Eric, and then it will also join that exclamation point. So let's try one more time. What's your name? My name is Eric. Hello, Eric. Awesome. Very, very cool. Actually, we can go one step further and actually put a comma here after hello. Do it one more time just to be perfect. Hello, Eric. But very cool. That is your join block. So we see this next block here. Letter one of world. What use does this have? Well, say we want to use an abbreviation. So some people call me E. So we'll say the first letter of the name. So we'll take our answer out here and say, you know what? I don't want you to say the whole answer. I want you to say letter one of the answer. Okay? So that's just going to be E, right? So I'll put it back in and say, I want you to say hello, first letter of answer. So what's my name? My name's Eric. You're going to say hello, E, the abbreviation. Again, very, very cool. So we look at this block down here and it says length of world. So when would we use this block? Well, say we don't want to accept a username that's over 10 characters long. So we'd want to do an if loop and say, you know what? If you type in more than 10 characters in your answer, say something. Maybe like that's too many characters. So we'll go ahead and we'll get rid of this for now. We'll detach it and we'll create a loop, okay? And we'll say, if then else, okay? So if then else. So if our answer, if the length of the word exceeds 10, we want to say something, okay? So we'll go ahead and grab an operator block and say, okay, so if length of world, but we don't want world, we want our answer, exceeds 10, okay, so is greater than 10, we want, we'll put this in our if then. So if this exceeds 10, then do something. So we'll say something. We'll say, man, that's a long name. Or your name is too long. Okay. Else we'll just say welcome to the user. So again, you can see I'm missing the answer, so I'll just drop the answer in here. So let's go ahead and put a forever loop around this too, so it always is running. So we'll nest that in a forever loop. Okay, so this is complex. I hope this works first time. So we'll go ahead, we'll run our program, and we'll say, what is your name? Well, I want to do this, I want to exceed the length of 10. So I'll put Eric Joseph Schilling. So if all goes according to plan, this if then should say, well, that's over 10 characters, okay? So that name's too long, we can't accept it. Nice. Oh, I forgot to say your name is too long. It says yours is too long. So that's awesome. Now let's make sure this works again for if your name is the correct length. So we'll say, my name is just Eric. There you go. Pretty awesome. So you can see that you can build some very advanced sequences using these operator blocks. I hope you enjoy.